Colin Jackson stalking about. We hope got his bad one behind him last night in the second round. But what a first round run, 13.10. And he looked, as he strode through at the finish easily, as if in that first round he could have gone under 13 seconds. But of course, the tension's growing, the pressure's on, and the Americans in the second round and again in that last round clearly intent upon pressurising the British.
Well, you know, he's staying with Mark McCoy. He's actually training with Mark McCoy. Linford Christie, Mark McCoy and Colin Jackson were training together down in Monte Carlo. And Colin was telling me yesterday that he fully expects Mark McCoy to head him for the first three hurdles. There's no better starter in the world. And he says, what I've got to learn to do is not to panic when I see Mark McCoy ahead of me. But I've had a lot of practice at not panicking seeing Mark ahead of me. And he says, I think that plays to my advantage.
Well, the full lineup and this second semi-final includes the top three on time in the world this year. Philibert of France in lane number one. Otters, Italy in two. Tony Dees, America, the world number two this year in three. Mark McCoy, Canada, the world number three this year in four. Arthur Blake, America, in five. Valley of Cuba in lane six. Colin Jackson, the world number one. He's in lane seven. And Lee of China in lane number eight. The first four into the final. The world record held by Roger Kingdom at 12.92. The Olympic record also held by Roger Kingdom. That's at 12.98. 1670, Arthur Blake. Third in the American Championship, eighth in the last Olympic Games. Best time this season, 13.30. Trying to keep loose. The battle for the first hurdle is all important. You can upset the rhythm of your opponent if you arrive there first. Mark McCoy, as Brendan Foster was saying, recognised by Colin Jackson and most people as perhaps the best starter in the world. 1686, Tony Dees, the American number two, 13.08. Jackson looking thoughtful. His first round yesterday was beautifully clean. He had trouble, especially at hurdle four yesterday, which he crashed. And for a moment, he looked as if he may not stay upright, but he rarely makes mistakes. It's Philibert, French champion for the past 2 years, fifth in the last World Championship. Otters, his father, Eddie, set the Italian record in the Olympic Games in 68, 13.46. Tony Dees, American number two. Mark McCoy, twice the Commonwealth champion, Canadian number one. Arthur Blake, the American number three. The champion of Cuba, Emilio Valle, lane six. The British number one, European champion, European record holder, Colin Jackson from Cardiff. And from China, Li Tong. He's at Washington State, but the Asian record holder. The second semi-final, the Olympic Games at 110 metres hurdles. The top three ranked athletes in the world this year in this semi-final. Colin Jackson of Great Britain, Dees of America, McCoy of Canada. The first four go through.
Yes, of course.
There's a lot of twitching down there.
Well, the battle is often won when you get to that first hurdle first, I tell you.
Not sure that anyone's been penalised yet, but they were very unsettled. And the yellow marker has gone up on lane number eight, Li of China. The lineup again, they're taking their time. That's McCoy, he's in lane four. The full lineup. Philibert of France in one. Ottos, Italy in two. Dees, America in three. McCoy, Canada in four. Blake, America in five. Vare, Cuba in six. Jackson, Great Britain in seven. Lee of China in lane eight. The first four in this semi-final into the final later tonight. Out there, look like Arthur Blake. He's the man in lane five. Yes, it is. They're all taking it very slowly back, and their minds organized as well as their limbs. McCoy in the background, psyching himself up, staying loose. Blake is undoubtedly the man penalised. Settle down for the third time. Philibert of France in one, Ottos, Italy in two, Tony Dees, America in three, Mark McCoy, Canada in four, Arthur Blake, United States in five, Valley of Cuba in six, Colin Jackson, Great Britain seven, Lee of China in lane eight. The first four into the final.
Yes.
The third time they go. And McCoy got a brilliant start and Jackson away well. But it's McCoy of Canada leading. Also on the far side is Tony Dees. McCoy and Jackson coming through. He hit that one. But he's clean now. McCoy comes through to win it. Jackson second. Blake third. And in fourth place, it was Valley of Cuba. The time 13-1-3. And the message going around the stadium. But Jackson starts as favourite, came to the games as favourite, but he's got some real opposition. Headwind of 0.8. Jackson was away well, but McCoy away best. Training partners, these two, they know and respect each other, but Jackson's been the boss so far, but he hit that one. Now he's clean. Lobbed another. And another. So it's McCoy who had the pressure on the rest from the gun. McCoy comes through, Jackson second. In third place, Dees, fourth, Valley. Bit of an untidy run for Colin. It's two all right. Three unbalanced him. Six, just clipped it. Seven, really almost lost his rhythm completely. Well, he's got something to work on.
Well, I think the way looking at Colin there, that if he hurdles as we know he can, as technically well as we know he can, then I think the final, he's got a great chance. But the last two rounds he's had, he's really struggled on the hurdles. He can't afford that in the final.